So first things first, to get the page, we need the generic HTML. So let's start with that. That'll give us a nice shell of the page. Then, as we're getting that generic HTML, we can fire off requests for unique HTML. We can start to load the page with that generic HTML, and then finally finish it up with some unique HTML. The point being here that you can actually separate this generic from unique HTML, and you can start rendering the page, you know, rendering favorite cereal, favorite pasta, maybe putting up some space for an image, even before you start getting the unique HTML for things that are specific to me. This is a really useful technique for quickly rendering a page when custom content is involved. There's almost always going to be some type of generic HTML that the browser is going to need. So if we return it as fast as possible and render it as fast as possible, it'll make our app feel really, really fast. We can always fire off the request for unique HTML down the road and then just fill in that data once it arrives. You'll notice with your Facebook news feed, when it first loads, you'll see some empty stories. That's Facebook following the technique you see right here. And the same thing is true for Google searches. When you search for something, you'll see the header come back before the search results start filling in, because this is a really great trick for getting content on the screen as fast as possible.